everybody. This is Living Dread Girl with Locks, Knots, and Stitches, episode number 7. Thank you so much for joining me today. I live here in beautiful Rochester, New York with my son slash producer, Turbo Joe, my 3 dogs, 4 cats, Boa Constrictor, and Bearded Dragon. You can find me on Ravelry at SparklingWater000, Instagram at Locks_Knots_Stitches, and the best way to contact me is through email at locksknotstitches@gmail.com. Yay, I got through the intro. Just, woo, been a rough couple of weeks. So it's been week 3 instead of week 2 for the podcast. I did work overtime, yay! And I have proof that I worked overtime. But we'll get to that in a minute. So I'm just gonna look over here at my notes. All right. A couple of things you may have noticed. I did de-stash. I will talk about that in my What's New section. Another note thing. Some administration things. I will be running the giveaway for the 50th subscriber. I am making a project bag, and I will show you the stitch markers to go with it. I'm unclear of the yarn, so if you have any preferences, please let me know. Let's see what else I want to talk about. Oh, a couple more things. I had a little issue with the, sorry, my hair, I sit on it, with the bamboo needles. They're just a little too sticky at times. And so, anyone has any suggestions on other needles, I'll show you what I've tried thus far when we get to that part. All right, anything else? So I'll talk more about the de-stash and some other things as we go along. Alright, so let's talk about charity. The baby blanket. It is just in my bag here. It's bright, right? It's just a bag I got from the dollar store. Ooh, I'm in the middle of a row. Yeah, I'll explain more about that, why I'm in the middle of the road. It's actually a good thing about that. And I did take off the stitch marker, but, sorry. All the yarns are in that bag. Let me show you the bag real fast. It's a pretty decent sized bag. It has a little pocket right here. Nothing special. They work. They're strong. That's all I got for you. I don't have as much light in here today. I apologize. Oh, I bring it up further, you can see. So you can see, I'm bring this past my eyes, so I can't see, but you see the pattern. So probably, as you can see how big it is, let me bring it over here. So last time I was probably right here, and I'll tell you why I got more of this done. But I need to get it done. I need to work on it more, and I didn't. Oops, but I will. Real quick, again, I'll go over the stash, but I just have these left for the dogs. The dog and I think that's all of them in there. Yep. So, oh, there's one more that's hiding. So I'll show you. These are, I'm saving for the dog and cat's blankets. So, yeah. I made progress. Remember, it's going to be a whole bunch of stockinette stitch. And then, whoops, I get used to doing this on camera. And then I'm going to repeat this again. And let me bring this forward one more time. You can see how it's slowly progressed out. Well, it's kind of, it was like, so, bring it forward. It's really cool, right? Smile.
Alright, so.
And this is on number 9mm, not number, 9mm needles. Sorry, I do everything in millimeters. Alright, so that is all I have for charity. Again, I don't have a ton done, but as you know, I was working overtime. But real fast, I'm not sure why I'm putting this in the FOs, but so, I don't know. This monstrosity did not work out. I love the lace pattern. I don't know. I want to know what's going on. I did run out of yarn. Where at? Yarn chicken. I couldn't even finish that row. I don't know. I had previously tried to add another color in, but it didn't work out. It's so pretty, that lace. Let me stretch it out for you. It's so pretty, but I did learn that it, because too much. I did learn that some of the Norwegian patterns are a little bit harder for people like me to read, because they're far more skilled in this than I am, in addition to reading the pattern, so they kind of know, whereas I don't. So I don't know what this is right now, whether it goes to my dog or what, so I don't know. I wanted to do it and then do it in the acrylic yarn and then redo it in the other yarn, but I just cannot figure out the pattern. So, sorry. I will not call it a total loss right now. Alright, but my only true finished object, I don't know if you saw me on Instagram, is my son's sweater. So this stitch marker was where I was at last time. And I did not weave in the ends, so, you know, that's a thing. So I don't know if it's noticeable, but where am I? My placement of the raglan increases. I didn't do it necessarily correctly, but whoops, you know, it worked out. So it looks funky, but it worked out, and I will insert a picture. Let me move all the way over, because it's going to take up quite a bit. And we'll put it right up there. But I loved working on it. I just whipped it out. I was so excited. Yay! And, you know, maybe someone can weave in the ends for me. Just kidding. I will do that later. I actually finished it this morning at 1 a.m. So that was a thing. Luckily, it is like really late at night. It's like around 9 or something tonight. So I will show you the stitch marker, or the progress keeper. I got my two dogs sleeping right there. That I made. Sorry.
pretty cool, right? Oh, my dog. Aw, there she is. She gonna try to steal my seat, girl, just because I got up.
Y'all supposed to be quiet right now and relaxing. Alright, so another thing that happened was the sweater I was making for myself is gone. It's kind of done with it. The Tunisian crochet hooks were just sticking. The yarn was just sticking to that bamboo. It was just like glue. I just can't deal with it. I really think I like metal nice, something nice and slick. But with that said, don't worry, I'll start a sweater. But for now, my other whip, slowly grabbing it. Well, get my little button there. But okay, I'll just put this on here. So I'm knitting in the back loop. Pretty cool, right? And I'm not too concerned. With how it will go in. I'm just using the yarn, and however, like you see there, it's falling. You see there, nope, down one. And then, whoop. And you see there, I don't really care. I think overall, it's big, it's chunky, it's bulky, it'll look nice, and it'll wrap around nicely, so that's pretty cool. And this is their Bernat Softy Chunky. To 6 worsted weight, and it is lavender. Next one, same brand, soft and chunky, 6 worsted weight, and this is sea green. Huh? I thought it said something different. Sea green. And both of these are 108 yards, 3.5 ounces, 100 grams. And then the third color that fell on the floor is this one, same brand, that I want to do a simple border. And it is called Somerset Ombre. I'm reading it backwards, forgive me. Again, it's the 6 worsted weight, or 6 bulky, super bulky. And this is only 77 yards, 2.8 ounces. But those are some of the stuff I did not de-stash. I was going to make into a blanket immediately. It's from my aunt, so please don't tell her. It's a surprise. And then I will show you this languishing whip. And so it's going to be a teddy bear for my friend's daughter at work. This is how much I've gotten done. This is going to be an arm. So I think I'm going to make 2 arms, make the legs a little bit longer, obviously, and then I'll stuff it and sew it on, make the head and ears. I kind of let it languish. It's his life, right? So the first color is Aaron Fleck. That's all I got for you. And a Red Heart Super Saver. just a five, no, four words of weight. It's 90% acrylic. Other fibers is all I got for you. It's 260 yards. That's 5 ounces. Hope that focused, sorry. And the other color is, this is the Lions brand homespun yarn. This is Tulips. It looks hot pink to me, but it's Tulips. It does have like accents of orange in it, which is pretty cool. This is a 5 bulky, which is nice. 6 ounces, 185 yards. Let's see, it's pretty cool. So hopefully I'll get that done shortly, now that I have these stashed. And then I did take out the socks that were going to be this. I just couldn't do it on those needles, so I will eventually get that started again. And we'll see where that goes. And I think that is it for my whips. Obviously, I have still my blanket, my mom's blanket. I haven't worked much on, so. So, the other one of this one. Is on my son's sweater. And then the rest of those are just stitch markers. And I did buy the bigger rings. So I have bigger rings than that for larger ones. And the next one I will show is pretty cool. And there's another set of those. And again, you see the two stitch markers and then the progress keepers. And then, gotta find, there we go. So this set I made 2 and 2. And then there's another set I did the same thing with. There you go. Let me get some light on that. Pretty cool. I got some more ideas for these, but then this one again, these are just stitch markers. I couldn't figure it out, but let me show you just one. And these ones as part of my giveaway. They have to be baked. And those are some ideas. I'm gonna poke some holes in them. I wanted to let them dry out, so. I'm gonna bake them and paint them and gloss them over. So I thought those were some ideas. And my dog is back in my spot. Oh dear. And now she's trying to get my lap. Alright. So we will do some stash enhancements. Alright. First, let me show you. These are just some of the needles I've been trying. They're not terrible. Put the sizes up. But these are the Susan Bates Velocity. So for faster knitting, I was just trying these. I got them all for half off and one I got for free. Had an awesome shopping day. So I got the 5mm, 4.5 millimeter, and 4 millimeter. So I got the three sizes of these. And just to try those out. So we'll see how that goes. I know there's other ones as well. But, you know, for now, it is what it is. So, when I got the needles, I bought this. This is just, get my tag out. Peaches of Cream, right, no. Lilies, the original sugar and cream cotton yarn. it's 14 ounces, 400 grams, 706 yards, 645 meters. It's 4-ply worsted weight, and this is Key Lime Pie colorway. You know, you can get that, your Joann's, your Michaels. And I was just knitting something up. I think I'm just going to use this to, I'm going to close this bottom up and just clean my cages with this. I think the rest of this, I'm going to get my face out the way. I'm going to use this, to make washcloths. There's some batterns on the back, and I'm gonna use those as gifts. So I think that will be pretty nice. So now, on to what my overtime got me. So, let me, first up was, there was a trunk show at my favorite yarn shop, the Black Pearl. And the featured yarn dyer was Misha's Obsession. So it's Misha's Obsession. I will put that at the bottom. It's .etsy.com. Hand-dyed yarns, fibers. And so I think these are all Harry Potter themed, or a lot of them are. I don't know. So, this first one I just love. Tell me that's not beautiful. I think it would make a fun head wrap. Just untwist it a little bit for you. And this is 231 yards. It's a superwash merino. The color is, it's a Harry Potter theme, so forgive me. They do mean every flavor. Focusing, I apologize if it's not, but yeah, it's gorgeous. Again, I'll put her information down below. The next one, no, these next three actually, it's coming apart. Let's fix that first. All right, there we go. So these are going to be my Geyer shawl. It's a paid-for pattern on Etsy. So I'm going to make that. It's supposedly a really quick knit, which is nice. And I'm excited to make it. It's absolutely gorgeous. Nisha had it up and displayed. I was like, yep, I'm making that. The green one is Through the Woods. It's 100% Superwash Merino, DK. This one is Moody, Superwash Merino. Again, 231 yards. This one is the same thing. This is... Oh, Antiquated. So this is Antiquated, Moody, and Through the Woods. And again, this is Nisha's Obsessions.etsy.com. I will put the information down below. Should probably get my face out the way. There you go. I'm not sure, like, which combination. It should go like that. Or like that, but definitely a beautiful shawl right there. Alright, so next up, I didn't buy these all at once, but next up is Dream in Color Yarn, Mrs. Jilly. It's my dog getting up. Clutch! Lay down. I'll move machete for you. Put machete over here. This is... Well, you can see. I don't know if it'll focus. Oh, focusing on my dog. Well, anyways, it's so beautiful. This is they only made one of I think 34, I forget. They only made so many, excuse me. So, I don't know. So pretty. I had to have it. Oh, I'm sorry. This is Jilly. It is 100% Superwash Merino wool, 440 yards. And it's just called Lily. So, it's absolutely beautiful. All right, next up is a couple of, and I have these caked up, so I want to get these started, and they're all just unraveling right now. Well, I got these two caked up. So I got, here we go. And these are Blue Moon. This is by Signature Sock Yarn. This is a 80/20 Superwash Merino Nylon, 3 ply, 410 yards. I'll put it down below if you can see. Got a little different setup. I should have my camera closer, but I don't. As you can see, I'm further back against the wall. Nothing behind me. I got two of these. And then, I got... I should take out the tag so I can tell you about it. There you go. And this is, it's the same thing. This is called Smoky Quartz. It's a superwash merino nylon 8020, 3-ply, 410 yards. On the round, Archer's artisan yarning fiber, signature soft yarn. Sorry. Wow. It's on the yarn. My apologies. Doesn't want to do it today. There you go. Now I'll show you the back. It's being silly today. I'm sorry. I am too far back for this, but since I'm up here, I'll show you this next one, or these next two. Pretty cool, right? So this first one, again, is the 8020 fingering soft yarn, 385 yards, 3.5 ounces, 100 grams. And this is Ancient Arts yarn, and this is Storm Cloud. We'll turn it the right way. And that's kind of a purpley one, and this is more of a blue one. Same thing, and this is just called Forever in Blue Jeans. Blue. Let's see how cool it is. So I was really excited to get that. Some of this down here is probably the rest of it's gonna go. Yeah. So now that I went through all that, I'll explain what I did. I got rid of most of the acrylic yarn. There was a ton of it. I was not using it. Yes, some of it was beautiful, but I wasn't using it. I was getting overwhelmed with it. I don't have a giant home. And I found it great homes. So, this is, you know, I want, you know, in order to get more of the stuff I want, I had to get rid of some of the stuff I just wasn't going to use. So I want to be more, I want to be a better crocheter, better knitter, and I want to be more focused on things I'm doing. So, I got, you know, some of it just had to go. It was just a little too much for me personally. Not that I hate people with large stashes. I love it. Absolutely adore it. But just wasn't for me. It was too much. It was overwhelming. I tried. It's just too much. This isn't the first time in life that this has happened. I've tried other times with other things, and I've just thrown everything away. So I was a bit more methodical on it than just throwing it away. But so yeah, I feel much better now that I've destashed and made a lot of people happy, so it's pretty cool. So I'm just checking my notes, don't worry. Okay, so some of the things I'm learning. Still working on brioche. Surprise! My work schedule doesn't afford me time to often take lessons. Like I said, my favorite yarn shop, the Black Girl, they're new. So they don't have, they're, you know, working on it. I'm sure if I went down there, she would help me and whatnot. But guess what? I was down there today, and that's how I got some stuff done. So I think I'll be able to go down there next week, too. Yay! Problem is, it happens on a night that I'm usually pretty busy. These next few nights, I'm not busy. So that's a thing that's awesome. So, but it does pose an interesting issue. But I think I can work around it. So, I can come earlier in a day too. It's great, and just sit there and knit on Thursdays. So, she has offered that. So that's awesome. That makes things a lot easier for me. So hopefully I'll get that done. I am trying to learn on double pointed needles. And I figure, why not? The more I learn, the better, right? Having a hard time, but, you know, it's maybe not for me, but it's good to know, I feel. Like, well, at least for me, the more I know, right? So I'm starting. And then you're supposed to, I am in the middle of a stitch, so don't hate me. But I get it, so I'll work on that. Excuse me. The next thing is onto the animals. You're doing good. Come here. Ooh. This is my sleepy boy clutch. Can you put your head up to the camera? Look up. Show them. See? Show them you're awake. Yeah. How you doing? It's past his bedtime. It's late, so. Yeah, he's a little sleepy. My little guy here. You gonna say hi, Clutch? No, I don't know. Little machetes over here running around. So a couple things. Our bearded dragon's doing great. He shed several times, it seems like. Not that that's a bad thing. It means he's growing, he's eating. Maybe I should put a disclaimer. I won't put up pictures, put it that way. We're going to be raising dubia roaches to feed him. For those of you a little worried about roaches, they can't breed up here. I have to put them in a special tank with a heater and everything so they can breed in that tank. If they got loose in the house, they would eventually die. They're not pest-like animals, so he's going to lay back down there. So, it's pretty cool. They're not like your regular cockroach, so. But yeah, I'm going to start a colony, and then I'll probably sell the rest on Craigslist for people to get if they want some. Let's see what else my notes say. So something about my snake. My snake is doing good. If anyone knows anything about snakes and they want to help me out, I feel that he's a little on the thin side. I could be wrong. I did buy him mice, large mice, and they seemed really small for him. So, that's a thing.
Oh, she wants backup now.
So, I don't know. I'm almost like... Sorry, I'm just looking at his tank. I'm almost like large rats. Not large rats. Small rats. Excuse me, might be the next. I can insert a picture. Oh, there I go, this side. Right here. So, yeah. If you have any information, any thoughts, yeah, just let me know. I just want to show you, I bought the inner fabric for the bag. So it's going to be a plain fabric, and then this part will be the drawstring part, so it's just a little pop with this green, kind of like summertime in the winter. Or, you know, in the fall, whatever. So a little pop at the top, and then you can just kind of... Yes. You'll be able to fold this over. And just kind of work out of it like that. So that's pretty cool. So I will show you more of that on Instagram. But yeah. I believe I will double check for you that that is everything. Yay! I did it! Again, thank you so much for watching me. To all the new viewers, welcome. I appreciate it. To all the return viewers, again, I appreciate all the love and support. So thank you so much. Don't forget to check me out on Instagram. I am definitely like 100% crazy on Instagram. Ravelry, I apologize. I am not. if you have any questions, right now, I do not have an Etsy shop for the stitch markers and progress keepers. If you would like something, just email me. Let me know. I come from a retail background, so in order for me to want to make an Etsy shop, I would have to build up a lot of stock. And I think I showed you some of the stitch markers prior, so in some regards, I might have enough stock, but... I want to get some of the other ones made and baked, all that. So that's a bit of a process. Thank you so much, everybody. You're wonderful. Drop me an email about what prize yarn or types of yarns you want. And yay! I hope y'all are doing good. Stay positive. I know things are rough right now. Remember, I'm here to spread lots of love, no hate. Thank you so much. This is Little Dark Girl with Lots and Lots of Stitches. Bye.